1 seconds to go, and that is a lot of time.
Dunleavy reports in. Gene Shu telling him to tell everybody no fouls. They're down by 5 with 51 seconds.
And so again, Brent, Jack Ramsey electing to bring in Dave Forsett, the man that he feels can do whatever is necessary depending upon the situation. He wants them in there to settle them down.
Steve Jones has moved back here to courtside, and Steve, this is your hometown, and it's about to go crazy.
Oh, they're all getting ready to go bananas, but again, the game is not over until the gunner's gone off, and Philadelphia still has a chance. Portland has to move the ball and handle themselves a little bit better in this pressure situation.
3-point difference right now, Steve. Down toward 40 seconds. Torchick holding it up. Rose, Walton there, and they play catch. Shot clock down inside 10. Watch the game clock. A 3-point difference. 108-105. Torchick and Lucas cleaned it up with 28 seconds.
That is the big rebound of the game right there.
Lucky Powers with a whistle.
Gotten that rebound, Brent. They had a chance to make it a 1-point game. Anything could have happened. Let's watch the play. Forsett takes the shot. Got a good shot from the corner. Collins with good defense. Ball comes off. Maurice Lucas. The ball just had to take a good bounce because McGinnis had inside position.
Lucas at the free throw line. 27 seconds. After 7 years of frustration for this franchise, they are about to win a world championship. And for Bill Walton, 3 years and 200 miles of tape. Sport Magazine gives away a card to the most valuable player. We pick the most valuable player. There is no question in my mind. It is the big redhead, Bill Walton, who is going to get both honors. He'll probably take a camper van for the summer. He has been some force throughout. Bring them over. Just 27 seconds, and Portland, Oregon will erupt with a championship. That winter afternoon in Green Bay, Wisconsin, it was the Packers and the New York Giants. And the Packers played with such precision after having lost the title game the year before to the Philadelphia Eagles. Now it's a different sport, a different city, but the same feeling. Portland, Oregon, just 27 seconds away. The whole state of Oregon closing in on its first professional championship. Everybody will count the 27 seconds down. The magnificent Julius Erving goes off now to Joe Bryant. Walton rejects another one. Outside, McGinnis hits a field goal.
They're right there, Brent. Good defense. They make a steal. They can get back. Wisely, they call timeout to get the ball at half court.
Here we come. So the 76ers not quitting no matter what I or anybody else about to say. And look. Spectacular tomorrow in a foot race.
Good defenses. Three men around them. He passes off. Walt with a great block shot. A big break for Philly as the ball bounces back to McGinnis. McGinnis will pick it up, put it in the basket. And now Philadelphia's gotten himself within striking range, even though there's only 18 seconds to go. They will come in. They will pressure all over the floor, try to come up with the steal, hopefully to go down and score a basket and tie this game. If they cannot make the steal, when the clock gets down to somewhere around 6 seconds or 5 seconds, they more than likely will have to gamble and hopefully foul someone who is not a real good free throw shooter and hope that he misses at the free throw line.
18 seconds. A 2-point Portland lead for the Trailblazers. Torzik, Lucas, Walton, Gross, and Davis. For Philadelphia, Collins, Bryant, Dunleavy, McGinnis, and Irving. McGinnis has erupted in game 6 for 28. And the doctor, magnificent as usual, has scored 40 points in this game.
Brent, I can remember some of those series with the Celtics and the Lakers when an inbounds pass was stolen by Havlicek. He went down, scored, tied the ball game. Looked like the Lakers had it won.
Here is Gross, takes the inbound pass, and McGinnis is over there to tie him up. Jump ball in Portland. A jump ball with 16 seconds. George McGinnis, fired in a slump, has given the 76ers one last shot with 16. And a reminder, the Kemper open next, but don't go away from this. Suddenly, Gene Shue and the 76ers are breathing. They hang tough. It'll be Gross and McGinnis, 109-107. Philadelphia needing a break off the tap. It goes to free. They can tie it. Philadelphia can tie it. Turn out the doctor outside. Off iron. Free with a rebound. Seven. Gross is over there. Philadelphia with possession. They had their chances that time.
Maurice Lucas, I don't know where he's playing right now. If they take the ball in bounds, George McGinnis is wide open. I don't know what he's doing.
Here's McGinnis. Lucas comes out. McGinnis for the tie. It's off.
Shirley MacLaine.